program, I just had our last names, like the Beatles, you know, or their first names. I just had our last names. But Marek.
Well, if we perform in China, we just well.
Yes, I know.
Okay. So that's a program. The program is partly hidden. So when we reach the other part of the program, perhaps we shift it. Or
well,
I don't know. Maybe
we're going to get rid of this in a second.
Maybe we
I'll announce each piece anyway before we play. Hi, I'm Dr. Richard Boulanger. That's I'm very excited to be here. This is the Berklee Electroacoustic Music Ensemble. This is Kari Uusila, the Dean of Electronic. With these wonderful cameras, also the software, and performing them is Basil Simon. Basil, right here. Right now, Basil's a student at Berklee, but who knows? In 3 years, he'll be the chairman, and I'll be begging him for a sabbatical. We'll see. In any case, we're very excited to be here. I love Krakow, I love Marek Konievsky, I love the Audio Art Festival. I was a Fulbright professor here in 1990, come back as often as I can. When I came then, my youngest son was 5 years old, Philip, and he came back with me a few years ago and did a master's degree in cello performance at the Krakow Academy. So that was kind of cool, and so we really love Krakow. Don't we?
Yes.
It's true. So we're very excited to play for you. This first piece is a piece composed by Kari Uusila called Koti. And the piece, Kari will tell us, I think, maybe a little bit about it, because it's really beautiful the way it uses this oldest Scandinavian or Finnish lullaby. And so please tell us about the piece.
Koti means home in Finnish. And so when I was writing this, I was thinking about home, and therefore I have the traditional Finnish Tibetan prayer bowls to start it. That's a joke. But the Finnish Gantale, which was part of my life growing up, will introduce it. And then part of it is I took the oldest rune song from the Kalevala, the Finnish national epic, which is a few thousand years old. Who knows if the notes are correct or not in it, but it's been, because it's been handed down person to person. It's a beautiful little song. So that is interwoven in there. I was thinking about my little cottage in eastern Finland as I was writing it.
So hopefully you will enjoy it as much as I enjoyed writing.
Koti.
Koti. Thank you.
hard to believe there are two of him, but there are. I'm the other one, at least in the United States. And we became such fast friends in 1990. The American consulate had us traveling all over Poland playing concerts together. It's really great to be here. We thought we'd play one of my pieces, or with a piece of my software. The program is called Muse, and so this will be Vavel's Muse. And we're using leap motion controllers, which are these wonderful little things that look like a pack of chewing gum. And they track very, very well the finger position, the motion of your hands. They know when your hands are closed and open, how you're rotating them. And so we're going to use these to sort of pick little cubes out of the air and play a little bit of an ambient piece for you. My dear friend, Marek Konievsky. We would be playing the piece now, but you heard? Wait, it's my turn. Honey, kiss?
Honey, kiss.
I don't see that.
Here we go. Ready?
I'm ready.
Yes. So one, two.
What happens with it? It's no sound.
Thank you.
cubes and not marks, but you get the idea, right? Each page has a different set of sounds, and what we're able to do is sort of grab them and control them a little and move them around. And the thing that excites me about it, and should excite all of you, is that it uses C sound. Didn't you want to tell
that?
That's
quite important, that the soft is available.
Yes, yes.
You can download it.
Yes.
It's available for iOS, so
yeah.
For iPhone,
yeah.
For iPad.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not sure whether for iPod Touch. Where is it? Where's
all right.
iPod Touch?
All right. Want that touch? Sorry, it's gone. Okay, well, now we would like to continue with the program. Thank you, Mark. That was great.
Should we switch back to the program?
No.
I will
leave it there. That's nice. I'll put it back in a minute. Well, our next piece is a solo composition by Kari Ursula, and it's featuring the K-Bo controller. The K-Bo was developed by Keith McMillan. It's a sort of carbon fiber 3D sort of sensor. There are pressure sensors in it. It has accelerometers, and it has sensors for noticing the location of the bow in relation to the bridge. It has a variety of software processing algorithms that were written in MaxMSP by a student of mine, Barry Threw, for the Keith McMillan Company. And it's a really wonderful controller, but here's the deal. They stopped making them about a year ago, so we're hoping that you'll see how cool this is, and one of you will decide, I should make K-bows and make them available, these sort of smart violin bows and cello bows. I'm glad that Kari has one, and I have a couple too, but we need the whole world to have, you know, intelligent bows like this, and I'm sure that someone out here could make them. But Kari, would you tell us a little about this piece?
I think I was on a summer theme. My cottage in Finland, and then late in August, there are these bugs that come out. They're called bog and gadfly, and they buzz around and they bite you. And but some of you may have read Lord of the Flies, where Piggy and others talk to the flies, and the flies talk back. And so this is my little conversation with the Finnish summer gadfly.
Thank you.
duet called Sequentially Mutable Nebula. And there'll be sequences in it. And we'll feature the Nebula module. It was a Eurorack module developed by two of our alumni. And of course, there's C-Sound inside. It actually is a C-Sound module running the language, and it's kind of a revolution that they brought this powerful software synthesis language into a little Eurorack module. So we have two modular systems. We're going to play for you live and have a little fun. We hope you enjoy the piece. Sequentially Mutable.
Thank you. potential. Going from the top of your head to the bottom of your being, I want you to tense up each part of your body in succession. Wrinkle your brow. Wrinkle it very, very tightly. Now, relax.
Exciting about these modular synthesizers is that's where most of us started 30, 40 years ago, and I'm coming full circle now to get to play again and patch again. It's a blast. Now we're going to have a solo work by Michael Birillo called House of the Blue Light. Michael, do you want to tell us anything about the piece?
So this is a piece, I like to work with ambient sound and see where I can take it, see what I can use it for as raw materials. And this particular piece was a video and audio that I captured at the Jewish cemetery in Berlin a few years back. And I was looking at different mausoleums and finding these to be, you know, very spiritual places and very kind of magical places in their own way. And so what I wanted to do is just conjure the feeling of what was the spirit world that went on in this particular space. What happened when I left? What happened when the sun went down? What happened when the earth was left? So that's so it's called House of the Blue Light.
Thank you. photographic memories. It features the Matthews radio baton. This was developed by Max Matthews, the father of computer music, at Bell Laboratories. And it allows one to expressively play the computer. Two wireless radio transmitters and a giant radio antenna, and you can trigger beats and control volume and spatialization. The spatialization software was written by Basil Simon. So not only does he do amazing visuals and write amazing visual software, but he's also a fabulous composer and a programmer of all sorts of things. There are three movements to the piece. The first and third use the radio baton. The second movement features again, incredibly, the cabo. And Michael is transforming the cello, and I'm accompanying with sort of orchestral timbres. In 1 second, we'll be ready to go. Thank you. You know what we're going to do? We're going to not play this right now. Let's go on to the second set, Marek, and then I can get this ready, and then after they finish their set, we might end with just this number. Does that sound okay to you guys?
Yes and no.
Yes or no?
Because we need really rearrangement of the space. That's
I know, you're going to turn the chairs around.
Not only.
Oh.
We are moving ourselves also like two rows.
Okay.
And I don't know to tell them because it's a secret, you know. So that was I don't want to tell you about this, you know. That's the secret. So you didn't hear anything. So.
But
I spoke
any time. So we can't work reset things. So thank you very much. We're done.
No, wait a minute.
Because of the chairs.
No, we can make a small intermission.
Okay.
No, not because of the church, but we can make it a funny condition. How much time do you need to recharge?
Oh, 5 minutes.
5 minutes.
10 minutes.
Let's take it easy. Yeah. Proszę Państwa, troszeczkę oddechu świeżego. Można wstać z krzeseł, prawda, bo będzie problem. Nobody will see anything.
Thank you. Dobrze. Ja, ale to dobra technika. Maybe we talk about the collaboration with our company for 2018.
Next year.
Not all.
Thank you.
concert's over. It doesn't work. Sorry. We're done.
No.
Sorry. No, it doesn't work.
So the deal would be to take a chair, to go up with a chair, and move a little bit to this side, because of respecting the position of the opposite, because he's here and she will be here. So the scena jest z drugiej strony. Chodzi o to, żeby przesunąć się do różnych stron. Nie rozbijają butelek.
Watch it.
Mamy znakomitą grupę, która nie jest tylko z Poznania. To chcę powiedzieć na początku, dlatego że w niektórych informacjach pojawił się Poznań jako jedyne miejsce pochodzenia tej grupy. Zespół jest z trzech miast, od lewej strony Poznań, Toruń, Bydgoszcz, czyli Anna Zielińska z Poznania, Rafał Iwański z Torunia i Wojtek Jarna z Bydgoszczy. No właśnie też jeszcze jedna była tą pomyłka, że w tym koncercie Rafał gra na perkusji, a właściwie gra na bardzo mocno alternatywnej perkusji, która się składa bardziej z obiektów dźwiękowych niż z instrumentów perkusyjnych w tradycyjnym znaczeniu tego słowa. Właściwie cały czas mam problem, czy mówić w dwóch językach, jak po angielsku to coś innego. Właściwie, więc powiem Państwu tylko, so we have a message for you in English that usually I don't ask people to turn off the mobile phones, and even sometimes I ask you to keep it on, but because we like the cell phones and the sounds from cell phones and we natural environment here. But there's one exception when you are on the edge of the network, then the network produces some extra noises, and sometimes they really interfere with PA system, which happens several times during every case. Także to jest taka prośba, gdybyście Państwo mogli jednak wyłączyć wyjątkowo na ten koncert i na ten zestaw urządzeń, które tutaj są dzisiaj. Wyłączamy komu po prostu, czyli włączamy tak zwany tryb samolotowy. Siadamy do samolotu, wyłączamy.
pomówię, a tak naprawdę nie wyłączamy, to włączamy tryb samolotowy. I będzie ciszej troszeczkę. To był też ten auto switch, the mobile phone, to the flying phone. To jest flight phone, o airplane phone. Ivański Jachna.